Hello everyone, this is Captain Yasmin Malik. I welcome you all on behalf of Seabird International. I am an OET trainer here. So today I have come here with a good news that here we have our student of OET. She has cleared her OET in the last month, that is September. So Ankita, will you please share your experience with our students?
Yes. If I talk about my experience, I have learned many things here from Seabird. The staff here, they are so cooperative that they help us in every aspect of clearing for the exam, right? And I have learned many things from Yasmin ma'am, because in the end days, she helped me a lot to gain many kind of information regarding the examination. Everything I have discussed.
Okay, so that's really nice, Ankita. But I just want to know that how was your experience during your exam?
My experience during the exam, actually I also got stressed during the exam. But when I was appearing for the exam, I just forgot everything. I just concentrated on my examination. I read everything with concentration and that's why I'm able to appear the exam.
Okay, and will you please just tell us, basically most of the students, they face problem regarding their reading module and sometimes in their listening as well, because listening is the first module and most of the students, they lose their confidence while appearing in the exam. So can you just give a last tip to the students?
When it comes to talking about the listening module, just be concentrated, just listen to the audio with full concentration and just practice it again and again. When you are taking the training, just practice your listening module again and again, because it will help you to fasten your speed in writing as well. And just listen to it, what it is, what the audio is playing, right? And just highlight those questions. If it is given, write the symptoms, then just highlight the word symptoms and just listen to what symptoms they are talking about. Right, if they are talking about the present symptoms, then just write down the present symptoms, not the symptoms which the patient had in the past. So yes, these are the mistakes students commit, because they write down the whole thing which they have listened in the audio. So just write down those points which are mentioned, which are necessary, which are required from in the question. That's it.
Yeah, that's a really valid point, Ankita. So I think most of the students, they are going to appear in this October exam. So I think you are also having the fear of exam, is it?
Yes.
Okay, so do you want to ask some questions from Ankita? Okay, so Anmol, just share your what all fears you are having right now.
Thank you very much, ma'am. First of all, heartiest congratulations to you for the big achievement. The question I'm going to ask now is actually on behalf of the students who are going to appear for the exam this month. Actually, the thing is that, you know, we have already paid a lot of commitment for all the modules, but we want to know that in the last days of our training, what all things do we need to keep in mind just to build up confidence to appear for the exam?
During the whole training, we get so much stress, right? Because we have to appear for the examination. So in the last days, just be calm, because it is just an English examination. Nothing else than that. We are being tested for our English instead of our medical knowledge. So just be calm and go with the tips and techniques which our trainers have told us. Nothing else is required.
Thank you very much.
Okay, yes, Ankita has given a really nice point that you just have to follow the techniques. It's an only English exam, because most of the people, they are having that myth that they are going to assess the medical knowledge. They are not going to assess your medical knowledge. I'm just sharing this thing with the new students as well. Those who have just joined, I think you two students, you have just joined with us. So I just want to tell you this thing, that they are not going to assess your medical knowledge, right? And what about you, Satnam? You're also having problem in one of the module.
Yes, of course. I want to ask about the reading module. How to score good in reading last week in MCQs?
Okay, if I talk about scoring good grades in the part B of reading module, firstly, just be concentrated. Just assess what is the need of the question, right? You can underline those words, because sometimes it is written, find out the true one from the options. And what we do, we try to find out the false ones. So that is lack of concentration. Just be concentrated on the questions and what the question is asking from you, and try to find out answers according to the question. And you can give 2 minutes to each question. If you are not able to find out the answer within 2 minutes, just skip that one. You can do it at the end. So just do those questions which are easy for you to praise.
Yes, even I just want to add one more information that regarding the OMR sheet, please try to fill it as soon as possible, because most of the students, they are keeping that
tracing the answers, but they are not able to
fill their OMR sheets. So please try to fill it as soon as possible. Don't wait for the invigilator that person is going to catch hold of the sheet and they are not going to give you extra time to complete it. So Manju, I think you're also having some issues in speaking module. So do you want to discuss with her?
Yes, I have an issue regarding speaking module. Like in sometimes in community settings like home visits, so how we can start a conversation with the examiner or the patient?
Well, as you know that in the speaking module, it's just a journal conversation, right? You have to initiate a journal conversation with the patient. And if we talk about visiting a home, whenever we visit somebody's home to whom we are not that much familiar or we don't know about them, so what we do? We just rang the bell and ask about that person, right? So the same thing we have to do here. Firstly, just introduce yourself that yes, I'm one of the registered nurses. May I talk to Mr.
So-and-so,
the name of the patient. Only then you will be able to recognize the right person. So this is what is required in the home visit conversation.
Yes, you just have to recall those words like we used to, when we used to visit our patients in the hospital. I think the 5 rights we used to follow. Right person, right patient, and right drug, right time. So you have to keep that point in your mind, and then while you're interacting with the patient, you can just use that one, right? And I think we have some new students in our class. So I think you're also having some doubts in your mind. You're also a little skeptical. I can see your faces. So will you please tell me? I think you're also having some problem regarding the reading module. Please share it with her.
Can you please tell me regarding the strategies you have used just in your reading task?
The process the trainers have mentioned to you, just go through it, just implement all those things in your daily practice, and after that you'll be able to trace the answers very quickly.
Yes, of course. I think I have not discussed the strategies with you. We'll definitely be doing it tomorrow, as I have already announced. So the thing is, maximum point is that you can just focus on the process of elimination. That is important. I think I call it as a KBC strategy, Kaun Banega Crorepati strategy, the 50-51, that you can just apply on your reading module. That is going to help you a lot. So I hope most of the people, they are having problem with the reading module, right? So you are having fear with that module specifically. And yes, Yamini?
Yes, ma'am.
So is there any other thing you want to discuss?
Yes, there is a thing. Just like Sidnam, I have the same problem. I'm not able to, end up with the whole part. Yeah, I always skip the questions, or I'm not able to even find out the answers sometimes. So, as you said, that just manage your time, like for each question, 2 minutes. Yeah, but how would we able to know that 2 minutes are over? Because we don't have any stopwatch or anything that time, and time just flies that time. So
that is the best thing you can do. Is she has already told you so many times that you have to work on the concentration, and we have already done that activity on on Friday or Saturday regarding that one, that you have to just spend 2 minutes, and we have put a timer on that.
But that time we had a timer.
Yes.
Okay. So one thing I want to tell you, that they will provide you with a watch on the wall, so you can calculate your time through that. And if you are asking me that you are not able to find out the right answer, that where the answer is, you are not able to find out the location. So don't worry about it, because in the examination, they will specifically mention that in paragraph 4, and then they will write the question, right? So they have given you the location of the question. So it won't be difficult for you to trace the answer.
Yes. Okay. Yes. Even sometimes if you face a problem in those questions, like according to the article, in that question, I can understand that you might be facing problem. So you can just keep that question aside and just continue with the rest of the questions, and definitely you will manage the time. Okay, and I hope you will get good scores. Okay, so this is all from Ankita's side, and I just want to give you one more good news that she has joined us as a OET online trainer, and we are going to share her experience, and definitely that is going to help the other students to get good scores. And we are already having 20 online students right now from even from Pakistan, from Dubai, from Australia, New Zealand. I think she will be giving the better picture.
Yes, if we talk about online OET, we are helping many students to get online training, right? And right now we have 22 students all over the world.
Okay.
Right? And some students are from London. Even they are very much settled there, but still they want to migrate to other countries. So it is very helpful for those students who cannot attend personal classes, individual classes here. So it's the best option for those students.
Okay. Oh, thanks a lot. It's a new information, like we have now 22 students. Okay, so this is all for today, and I hope just get enrolled with Seabird as soon as possible, and we'll be helping you out for the tips and strategies and to get good scores in future. Have a nice day.